Now we will be going to perform the test that is called as a determination of voltage regulation by voltage regulation of silent pole synchronous machine. So first is the determination of direct access and quadrature access reactance for by slip test on silent pole synchronous machine and determination of voltage regulation. So this is the practical setup circuit diagram. This is a DC shunt motor acting as a prime mover. Here the field winding is connected with rheostat to adjust the speed required by the slip test. And this is our synchronous silent pole, say synchronous machine or synchronous alternator is there, star connected. Here the voltmeter is connected up to the 150 volt, and this is the voltage per phase is connected up to 0 to 150 volt, and whereas one ammeter, we will connect one ammeter to measure the current. Measure the current is say up to the 0 to 5 ampere. So this voltmeter not needed, we have connected per phase wire. So per phase current and per phase voltage is there. So between voltage to this one. And a three-phase auto transformer is connected. Here it is a three-phase supply is there, and this is the variable point is connected. Auto transformer variable point, that is the outgoing terminal, is connected to the alternator. This is the practical setup, and this is the excitation. And for the this one, we will keep the excitation is open. So this is the practical setup, but we are not providing any type of supply here. So it is better to represent as a open circuit. So we will represent as a open circuit field winding. So field winding is kept open. So there is no excitation. Open circuit on field terminal. So field terminals are kept open. Okay. This is the alternator. Up to this one, it is a alternator is there. Three phase alternators are there. Okay. Now what is the procedure? Procedure is that first bring the speed of synchronous speed of DC shunt motor near to the synchronous speed, and increase excitation or increase the supply voltage from the external source, three phase supply, to the auto transformer. This is our three phase auto transformer. Now when we give the three phase voltage to the alternator whose field winding is open, we find some current is say it goes to the minimum value, maximum value, corresponding to the voltage also it's the maximum value and minimum value. So our voltmeter and ammeter is going to start oscillating to its minimum value and maximum value. So adjust the voltage supplied to the motor in such a way that there is a maximum deflection over the ammeter as well as the voltmeter. Or if you are not getting the, by changing this voltage, adjust the speed near to the synchronous. It should not be equal to the synchronous speed. Say for example, the synchronous speed of the alternator is 1500 RPM. So speed may be 1480 RPM. It may be a say 1490 RPM. It may be a 1515 RPM. And 1525 RPM like that. So it is not equal to the rated frequency, rated speed of the alternator, but there is a some slip. Therefore, the name becomes slip test, where we are keeping the slip value in the synchronous alternator. Now, as soon as it will give some particular value of field current, particular value of the speed of the DC shunt motor, and particular value of the this voltage. Auto transformer voltage, we find there is a maximum swing in the voltmeter as well as the ammeter. Now write down this value, that is the ammeter voltage, where it will give the maximum voltage. Say it is a 75 volt is the maximum, and minimum voltage is say it is equal to 65. Corresponding to this swing of voltmeter, there is a maximum swing of current and this one. So here say for example, the maximum value is 1.5 ampere and minimum value is 0.5 ampere. It is not the correct value. I am just writing to understand what would be the reading of the test over here. So write down 4, 3, 5 values are there for the such type of means you adjust the speed below synchronous speed, some values above synchronous speed, change the voltage supplied to the auto transformer, and try to observe that there is a maximum swing in voltage, maximum swing in the ammeter reading, and maximum swing in the voltmeter reading, and write down the corresponding value. Now, what would be the calculation? What would be the value of XT and XQ? So now calculate here the value of XT and value of XQ. So the value of XT and value of XQ is given by the formula. The value of XT is maximum value of armature voltage per phase divided by minimum value of armature current per phase. It means that whatever the maximum swing of armature voltage, say 75 volt, and minimum value of current is 0.5, so the 75 divided by 0.5 is the XT value. Similarly, XQ is the minimum value of armature voltage. Minimum value of armature voltage means when the voltage voltmeter gives the swing of minimum and maximum, so you have to measure the value of minimum value of voltage divided by maximum value of armature current corresponding to the same speed, which is less than or above the synchronous value. So by this way, we are able to calculate the XT and XQ. Definitely, the value of XQ is smaller than the value of XQ, isn't it? So now we have determined the value of XD and XQ. Now how to calculate the voltage regulation for the silent mode synchronous motor? So this is the vector diagram of silent mode synchronous alternator, where the current is lagging at an angle of theta with respect to terminal voltage, and internal power factor angle is psi. It has two components. One is the direct axis component, second is the quadrature axis component. Armature resistance drop in phase with the armature current, and direct axis reactance drop in quadrature with the direct axis current. So it is IDXD. Similarly, the value of IQ drop, that is the quadrature axis reactance drop in quadrature with the current value. So IQXD. And therefore, this will give the total value of excitation EMF is EF. Okay. So here, the internal power factor angle psi is Ia XQ plus Vt sin theta divided by Ia Ra plus Vt cos theta is there. So we can able to calculate the angle psi. Once the angle psi is calculated, it is easy to calculate the value of Id and XQ. Value of Id and IQ. So Id and IQ is calculated. And angle delta, this angle between the excitation EMF and terminal voltage is the load angle psi minus theta for the lagging power factor. Now, what is the total EMF induced in the alternator? It is equal to EF is equal to this vector Vt cos delta plus this resistive drop as Ia Ra is there in this axis. It is IQ Ra plus IQ Ra plus this is equal to IDXD. This IDXD. Now, everything is known. IQXD is known. Now it is easy to calculate the percentage regulation is equal to EF minus VT divided by EF into. So by this way, determination of voltage regulation or voltage regulation can be found. We come to know that the voltage regulation of silent pole synchronous alternator cannot be determined by EMF method, MMF method, and ZPF method. So this is the way to determine the voltage regulation. First, find the value of XT and XQ, and from this value of XD, XQ, draw the vector diagram and estimate the excitation voltage. Now we will move to the practical performance of determination of direct axis and quadrature axis reactance for silent mode synchronous machine by slip test and determination of voltage regulation of silent mode alternator.